Dear friends, welcome to this channel. We will solve one problem on single phase networks. Problem is like this: find current in 30 ohm resistance in the following circuit. Applied voltage is 4 volt at a frequency of 1000 divided by 2 pi hertz. Impedance of the supply is negligible. Dear friends, we will solve this problem using Thevenin's theorem, as it is the easiest method, and here we have to find out current only in the 30 ohm resistance. Here we are given frequency as 1000 by 2 pi hertz, and here we are given this inductance values as 20 millihenry and 60 millihenry. So we can write omega L1 is equal to 2 pi FL. 2 pi f is 1000 divided by 2 pi into l. L is 20 into 10 raised to power minus 3. So this we can write, this cancels with this and this cancels with this. So we are left with 20 ohm. Similarly, omega L2 is 2 pi f is 1000 divided by 2 pi into 60 into raised to power minus 3. This cancels with this and this cancels with this, so we are left with 60 ohm. So for applying Thevenin's theorem, we will draw circuit in which the terminals V and C will be shown as open circuited, and we will find out the voltage across the terminals V and C. So let us draw like this. So here it is 4 volt and this is 20 ohm and this is j20 ohm and this is 60 ohm and this is j60 ohm. This is A and this is B and this is C. See, now we can write is V as VA minus I1 R1. Say this current is I1 and this current is say I2, and this resistance we call R1 and this we call R2, and VC will be equal to VA minus I2 into R2, right? So we can write VB minus VC as VA minus I1 R1 minus VA plus I2 R2. So this will be equal to, this cancels with this, so we are left with I2 R2 minus I1 R1, right? I hope it is very much clear. See, we can write I2 as I2 as 4 volt, this is 4 volt divided by 60 plus J60. Oh, sorry, this is 50, sorry. 50 plus J60. Multiplied by 50, right? Minus I1 is 4 divided by 20 plus J20 into 20, right? So this we can simplify. So this we can simplify. See, we will take this 4 common and 50 divided by 50 is 1 plus J1.2 minus 4 divided by 1 plus J1. So this we can write We'll take 4 common. This we can write 1 plus j1 minus 1 minus j1.2. Right? And we multiply this by this. So this becomes 1 plus j1 plus j1.2 1 plus j1 and 1.2 and minus j square 1.2 and j square is minus 1, so it is minus 1.2, right? This we can further simplify. If this cancels with this, we are left with 4 into minus j 0.2 and here it is minus 0.2 and plus j 2.2, right? So this we can write minus 4j divided by this becomes minus 1 and this becomes j 11, right? So, or this we can write 4j divided by 1 minus j 11, right? So, this is our V minus VC, or this is called, if we can call as VTH, V Thevenin. So, V Thevenin we can write 4j divided by 1 minus j 11, right? Now, we have found out V Thevenin. Now, we will find out R Thevenin. For finding out R Thevenin, we will find out the resistance between terminals B and C under the condition when the source is short circuited. So, we will sort this source, right? This we sort, and we will find out the resistance between terminal B and C. Right? So, when this is short circuited, so this terminal, let us say this terminal is D here, please. So AD becomes one point, or A is sorted with the B. So these two, 20 ohm and j ohm, will be in parallel. And this will be in series with the current combination of this 50 ohm and this 60 ohm. So ZBC we can write, ZThevenin or ZBC we can write. See, 20 into j 20 divided by 20 plus j 20. Plus 50 into J60 divided by 50 plus J60 will be ZBC. Right. So, this becomes J20 divided by 1 plus J1. Right. Plus J60 divided by, this becomes 1 plus J1.2, right? So, we will simplify it. This becomes J20 plus minus J square 24 plus J square 24. So, minus 24, right? J20 and J square minus 1 and 20 1.3 24, right? Plus J60 minus 60, J square 60 is minus 60 divided by, this is 1, 1 plus J 1.2 and this is plus J 1 minus 1.2, right? So this we can write further as, this minus 84 plus J 80. Because this and this is 80 and this minus 84, right? So this becomes minus 0.2 plus j 2.2, right? So this we can write 84 minus j 80 divided by 0.2 minus j 2.2, or dividing by 0.2, the numerator and denominator we get. This is 420 minus j 400 divided by 1 minus j 11, right? So we know Z Thevenin or Z BC. Now we can write I will be equal to this 4j divided by V Thevenin, 4j divided by 1 minus j 11 divided by 30 plus this impedance, 420 minus j 400 divided by 1 minus j 11, right? So this becomes 4j divided by 30 minus j 330 plus 420 minus j 400, because we multiplied this by this, put it here, and then this cancels with this, so we are left with this current. Or we can write this current as 4j divided by c. This becomes 450 minus j 730, right? So absolute value of I will be given by 4 divided by t square plus 730 square equal to how much? This comes 4.664 milliampere. So dear friends, this is our answer for this question. This is our final answer. We are current through 30 ohm resistance. If 4 volt AC supply is applied at this frequency. So dear friends, this is how we can find out this current using Thevenin's theorem. Other method is loop analysis, we can use and find out this current. But that will lead to 3 equations and we'll have to solve 3 equations involving complex quantities. Another method may be assume this current I, this current I1, I2, and this current I1 minus I, and this current will be I2 plus I, then write the voltage equations and then solving the equations. These other 2 methods are of course possible, but chances of committing in those mistakes are very high, because you will have to solve 3 equations involving complex quantities. This is the easiest and the straightforward method. So try to use only Thevenin's theorem when we have to find out current through one resistance in any circuit. Dear friends, thank you very much for visiting this video. Kindly like it and share it with your friends, and further kindly subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.